Hello friends, in this video I am going to talk about super lightweight blocks which we can use in construction. There are many brands available in the market for lightweight blocks such as Geofoam, Durablock, Modi Foam, Filcor, Nidaplast, etc. All these brands offer the same product. The basic material in these lightweight blocks is expanded polystyrene. Expanded polystyrene means EPS is a super lightweight closed cell rigid plastic foam. EPS is approximately 1% the weight of soil and less than 10% the weight of other lightweight fill alternatives. As a lightweight fill, EPS reduces the loads imposed on adjacent and underlying soils and structures. Composition. Expanded polystyrene is a rigid and tough closed cell foam with a normal density range of 11 to 32 kg per m cube. It is usually white and made of pre-expanded polystyrene beads. Expanded polystyrene EPS or extruded polystyrene XPS manufactured into large lightweight blocks. The blocks vary in size. Uses: roadway construction over poor soils, roadway widening, bridge abutments, bridge underfill, culverts, pipelines and buried structures, compensating foundations, rail embankment, landscaping, architectural, green roofs, retaining and buried wall backfill, slope stabilization, stadium and theater seating, airport runway and taxiways, foundation for lightweight structures. Manufacturing of EPS. Raw beads are expanded using steam, creating pre-puff beads which are then cured in large bags before being conveyed to the mold. Once in the mold, the pre-puff beads are again steamed to form a block. The blocks are then placed on the storage floor to age for the appropriate length before being cut into various shapes and sizes. Blocks are produced in several densities to meet specific project needs. Advantages: can be cut to any size. EPS can be cut and shaped either at plant or site to create any architectural and landscaping profiles. Weight: EPS geofoam is about 100 times lighter than soil and much lighter than other lightweight fills like cellular concrete, shredded tires, pumice, wood chips, etc. Strong: despite its low weight, EPS is strong enough to support traffic and landscaping equipment loads. Compressive strength: EPS is engineered for high strength with compressive resistance values of 2 to 15 psi at 1% strain. Easy to handle: the material is easy for workers to carry and place by hand. Skill training not required. Installation does not require much skill training. Chemical resistance: EPS does not decompose nor is affected by road salts. Petroleum products and other chemicals can damage EPS, so incorporation of protective layers or barriers is used. Example given: soil cover, concrete slabs, geomembranes, etc. Long lifespan: the EPS can be recycled. No rotting because of damp weather. Reduced construction time: the ease and speed with which EPS geofoam can be constructed results in shorter construction time. Precautions while laying EPS blocks. Buoyancy: because of its closed cell structure and lightweight, EPS is buoyant. It can be minimized by installing EPS above the water table and ensuring suitable drainage. In addition, it can be counteracted by placing overlaying soils, pavements, sidewalks to sufficiently offset uplift forces resulting from buoyancy. Combustible: EPS is combustible when exposed to an oxygen source, so it is important to cover with non-flammable materials, that is soil, etc., and include a flame retardant. EPS is usually isolated by membranes, soils or pavements in the finished application. Water absorption: EPS has a closed cell structure that limit water absorption. When used in well-drained conditions, no change in EPS weight is expected over time. Laying process: an adhesive compatible to EPS is used for bonding with bottom surface and interlocking between the blocks. Geotextile membrane of 150 GSM on blocks shall be placed with minimum overlap of 50 mm. In my building project, I have used 100 mm concrete screed of M30 grade as a protective cap on top. Things to know about lightweight filling blocks before buying it. EPS density. You should know your load requirement and accordingly you can select the density of EPS block. Compressive strength. You should know where you are going to use it, whether it is high traffic area or low traffic area. Bedding material. What kind of bedding material is there? Is it RCC or soil, etc. that we need to check. Block dimensions. As per site condition, we can derive the sizes of blocks to minimize the wastage. Flame resistance, moisture absorption, decay, block layout and placement, cover and UV protection, concentrated loads, stability of adjacent ground, settlement, bearing capacity. All these things we have to consider before purchasing EPS blocks. Now the final aspect is cost. The cost of EPS depends on density. If density is low, then the cost is high and vice versa. For your reference, I can tell you the cost. In my building project, I have purchased the EPS at 4300 rupees per m cube for a density of 14 kg per m cube. So friends, I tried to cover all the information about expanded polystyrene lightweight blocks, which is a very good construction material. If you like this video, then hit the like button. If you have any doubts or any additional information about EPS, you can post a comment. Subscribe to Engineering Motive for more such videos and do not forget to press the bell icon to get the latest updates. Finally, thanks for watching.